Hi. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to jUnit. jUnit is a framework to write and run repeatable tests in Java. To help you write unit tests, jUnit provides an assertion library that is used to evaluate test results and an application to automatically run the tests you created. Let's look at two main advantages of using unit tests. One of them is that no human judgment is required. This avoids scroll blindness. Sometimes programmers use print statements to track the state and the correctness of the code. When the number of print statements gets too big, humans tend to be affected by something called scroll blindness. This is a state when they are no longer able to process information in a meaningful way and they scroll right past the very output in front of them that indicated a problem. Another main advantage is that it is easy to run many tests repeatedly. This allows us to catch regression. So as changes are made to a software, it happens that errors are accidentally introduced in code areas that were already tested before and used to work correctly. That's a regression. Making it easy to run many tests over and over again by using automated testing allows us to catch regressions early on. Here are some key features of unit tests. When you create unit test, you add the tests incrementally. That means you write some code, you write a test. You write more code, you write more tests. Whenever bugs are found, tests are updated. Sometimes you have a unit test and you find a problem in the code anyhow. There is a temptation just to go in, fix the code. But it's a very good idea to go in and fix the test. Make the test fail and then fix the code. This way you guarantee that the same problem cannot occur a second time unnoticed. Whenever the same problem happens again, it will be caught by the unit test. Here are some key features regarding running unit tests. Unit tests are run automatically. This is the main feature. They are evaluated automatically. We talked already about the benefit of avoiding scroll blindness by automatic evaluation. jUnit and many other unit test frameworks give your program a visual feedback. So typically you have a green bar. If all the tests pass, you have a red bar. If at least one of the tests fail. You also have a choice whether you want to run the tests for the entire code base or a limited amount of tests. Here is the possibility to choose whatever is appropriate. A quick kudos to the creators of jUnit, Kent Beck, computer scientist from the United States, and Erich Kammer from Switzerland. This is the end of part 1 of my introduction to jUnit. In part 2, we're going to create some unit tests in code.